be legalised to end the embarrassment of domestic drugs policy. According to a cross-party group of MPs, they've estimated changing the UK's drugs laws would bring in more than £1 billion a year for the Treasury. Well, to debate that, we're joined by the Conservative MP, Peter Lilly, who's calling for the legalisation of cannabis. He joins us from Westminster. It'll bring in tax revenue from the government, that is true, but what else do you think legalisation would really achieve?
Well, it will end the greatest harm that the present situation involves, whereby people who do use cannabis can only get it from illegal gangs who often push them to take hard drugs as well. So we're pushing soft drug users into the arms of hard drug pushers. And we're also creating a vast industry for drug gangs, which gives them a lot of income, which would be better channeled through an illegal outlet, taxed. I'm not in favour of encouraging cannabis use. I've never taken it myself. And that's probably why I've got a clear enough head to see that our present policy isn't working.
I mean, you say that, you know, that you have a clear enough head and that you don't want to push people into the hands of drug pushers. But there is a great deal of evidence that starting using cannabis does lead to other drugs. And it's not just because your pusher happens to sell more than one kind of drug. People want a different hit, a bigger fix. And cannabis has been shown to then lead on to people becoming addicted to other much, much stronger drugs. And that's the argument why we shouldn't legalise it, isn't it?
I don't think that is so. In the Netherlands, for example, it's legal to use cannabis, but as a result, people get it from legal outlets, and far fewer people in Holland go on from using cannabis to using hard drugs because they're not in contact with people pushing those drugs.
Do you have any concerns that it's normalising drug use? I mean, this is drug use. It's something that we shouldn't be encouraging, full stop, whether it's a Class C drug, a Class A or a B drug. And by making something like cannabis available legally, it is, in a sense, normalising it.
Well, I think it's important that we recognise there's a difference between things being right and them being lawful. Lots of things which are wrong, you know, like adultery, but we don't try and make that illegal. I'm not encouraging anyone to use cannabis. I wouldn't use it myself. I would discourage children from using it. But I think if we devote most of our drug control resources to preventing cannabis ineffectively, we don't control the hard drugs which do far more damage.
Having said that, if it is legalised, there will be people who will say, oh, you can get this legally. This isn't illegal. This isn't bad for me. I should be able to use it, and it makes it more normal, and it could lead to the numbers of people taking cannabis increasing.
Well, one's got to explain why in the Netherlands fewer people use cannabis than in this country, even though it's legally available. We haven't succeeded by making it illegal in stopping people using it. We have discredited the law, we've created a vast industry for criminals, we've put people on the route from soft drugs to hard drugs, and we've avoided having a potentially useful source of revenue for the government. And we haven't even made it available for medical uses.
What about the school of thought that because cannabis is illegal, that some people who would possibly use it are fearful, some people who want to avoid prison or who want to avoid a criminal record, if they are caught with it, will go into rehabilitation and will stop using it. Therefore, the fact that it is illegal is proving a deterrent to some people.
Well, as I say, there doesn't seem to be overmuch evidence, given that in countries where it is legal, the rate of use is either lower or about the same as in Britain. And some people think even the hint of illegality about it adds a little, interest and excitement to young people to take it. I think it should still be wrong to sell cannabis to underage people as it is to sell alcohol and tobacco.
What do you feel about the use of it for medicinal purposes? Do you feel confident? Are you comfortable that there's been enough research done into the possible positives and indeed negatives of cannabis use for people who are using it for illness?
Well, clearly, if it's going to be prescribed for medical purposes, then it should go through all the tests of any other drug. But if people use it because it relaxes pain and eases their suffering, then, and it's in safe form, then I see no harm in that.
What about the health implications of people who have very, very adverse reactions to it. There's a lot of evidence that, young people, young men especially, react very badly, some of them, to taking marijuana, especially to the stronger skunk varieties, and it can lead to really significant mental health problems. Whether or not it's people in large numbers, for the small numbers of people who do take it, it can have a really, really negative effect. Do you still feel comfortable knowing that it could be legalised?
Well, one thing we can do if we sell it legally is have health warnings on it and at the places where it's sold, so that people who've got conditions with which it would react adversely will be warned of it, as they're not at present.
It doesn't stop young people drinking or smoking, though, does it? They know that's bad for them too.
Well, it stops some of them. You're not allowed to sell alcohol and tobacco to underage people. You shouldn't be allowed to sell cannabis or other drugs to them either. But we won't entirely prevent that, and we certainly haven't prevented it at present. So it's not as if the present system was working.
OK, Peter Lilly, good to talk to you. Thanks very much.
Pleasure.
Barack Obama has warned Donald Trump he may...